seconds count, help can't be 30 minutes away. As Sheriff Chris Gideon will put more deputies on our roads to get to your family when you need them most. He knows Tangipahoa Parish, and he's committed to protecting you and your family.
I'm Chris Gideon, and I know Tangipahoa Parish.
What a great occasion it is here at Emmanuel Baptist Church in Hammond as Kendall Duncan is being inducted as a full Eagle Scout and the first female Eagle Scout in Tangipahoa Parish. Congratulations.
Thank you so much. It is a real honor to be here today. I have been working so hard for this, and I'm happy that all my work is coming to such an amazing moment.
And your dad, Brett Duncan, he was an Eagle Scout.
Yes, I'm here because of him. It was, he's the one that introduced me into scouting, and I wasn't allowed to even join scouting until 2019, and I didn't join until 2020. They didn't let girls in and before that, so.
What was the advantage then of being able to get into scouts instead of Girl Scouts?
Well, into the scouts, we can go on more campouts and do more activities, and plus you can do some activities co-ed. And there's just so many more opportunities with advancement. We work towards your advancement in scouting, while in Girl Scouts, it's more of age.
So what did you have to do to qualify?
I had to learn the scout oath and the law, and then I had to be 11 first. Once you were 11 or in sixth grade, then you can join into scouting. And then once you join, you can advance through work.
Did you have to get a lot of merit badges?
Yes, it does require a lot of merit badges. I have 35 myself, but there's some Eagle required merit badges like communication, family life, camping, first aid, a bunch of useful skills that you would need just to be a human being today.
So getting that 35 merit badges, I mean, that was a great education in itself.
Yes, there was so much education before. I've learned so many things, and it helps me to figure out what career path I want to go into in the future.
What about the camaraderie in scouting that you get?
Yeah, there's so many friends you can make, and you get to meet new people. Some of the merit badge counselors come from professionals in that skill, and you can meet with them, and if you end up wanting to go on the career path, you already know somebody who's in it.
Well, plus, I imagine that some of the jamborees and the other activities you go to are a lot of fun.
They are amazing. I went to the one this year, and I got to meet people from other countries. I have a friend in the Philippines that I'm still in contact with, and then I have some friends from Tokyo, China, and I also got to do so many cool things that I can't even do in Louisiana. We got to go do, I guess, kayaking and rock climbing and so many other amazing things that I couldn't even dream of doing here.
Well, what's next for you? Isn't this like the pinnacle of scouting?
I'm going to continue into scouting as the Junior System Scoutmaster for my Troop 2020. And then hopefully maybe whenever I age out, I can continue to be in scouting as maybe an Assistant Scoutmaster or Scoutmaster, because this is such a great organization and I don't want to leave it.
So you would recommend scouting?
Of course I would recommend scouting. Scouting is an amazing organization. I have so many friends here, and I couldn't live a life without it.
So is it making gains, do you find, among girls or among, for that matter, just boys and girls?
Yes, there's so many gains into being in scouting. You get to learn so many life skills. I make friends for life and go on so many experiences that you can't do on your own.
I'm just curious, what happened during the pandemic? I mean, that must have slowed you down quite a bit.
I actually didn't start until the pandemic started. My brother actually needed a requirement where he needed somebody to come to a meeting for him to advance, and I was just allowed to join scouting, and I didn't even know that there was a troop in my area. So I went to Cameron's Zoom meeting, and that's how I joined in. I found out that there was a girls' troop through that meeting, and then I joined on from there. And then we filmed, me and my brother filmed each other doing requirements, and then we also earned merit badges on our own just by filling out packets. It's not the same, but we still did it.
Plus, I mean, that was only a couple of years that you were able to make this accomplishment. Usually it takes longer than that.
Yeah, I mean, it depends on the scout. I did it in 3 years. My brother's on his fifth, and he hasn't earned it yet. I take pride in the fact that I beat him at it. And it depends on the scout. But some people are more dedicated. You can do it in 2 years. Some people do it in five. But you have until from your 11 till you're 18 when you age out.
So you have quite the resume for a young lady. You're the Young Woman of Excellence for the Parish Library System and an IB student at Hammond High.
Yes, I'm a junior in the IB program right now. I'm taking 7 college-level classes, and then I'm also taking a piano class and a secondary class online. And the Young Woman of Excellence Award, I didn't even know that I was getting that for a while. And my talented theater teacher nominated me for it, along with my piano teacher.
Well, I think you would agree that your dad would never forgive us if we didn't put in a plug for the magnet tax renewal that's coming up.
Of course. I am a huge fan of the magnet program. I've been in it since I was 4. I went to Hammond Eastside for 10 years where I did the company program where I got to do musical theater. And then now I'm in the IB program at Hammond High with a bunch of people from different backgrounds. It's a very diverse group and a diverse school. And I get to do so many cool things that I wouldn't be able to do if the magnet tax didn't exist. And I'm just, I don't know what would happen if we lost it. And I'm kind of scared for what would happen if we did lose it.
What else do you want to tell us on this great night for you?
I just want to thank all of the people that have supported me. I have a lot of accomplishments under my belt, but I would not be able to do it without the people that I have around me. I'm surrounded by a bunch of amazing people, whether it's through the Magnet Program or Scouts BSA or the Tangible Hope Parish Library. There's so many people, great people in the world today, and some people look towards the negative, but I'm looking at it in a positive direction. And I mean, there's so many great people in the world, and I'm just grateful that I'm here today.
Travel back in time to experience the Middle Ages at the Louisiana Renaissance Festival. Explore the English village of Albright at the height of the 16th century and enjoy jousting tournaments, dueling, juggling, magic, and falconry. Meet the Queen. Experience the charms of musical minstrels. See real blacksmiths, glass blowers, candle makers, and so much more. And shop for fantastic and unique items you can't find anywhere else. The Louisiana Renaissance Festival.